This video is brought to you by AKSIAS.
Okay, last question, don't curse me. Okay, the girl to the right there, she will, yeah, you. Yeah.
So this is a question to Anudeep sir. Actually in 2017, I left my job and I came to civil services. So 3 months I went for coaching and there I left my coaching and I came back and I studied for 2 months. Then I gave my first attempt in 2017 and I was topper at 79 in scoring that attempt. Then I started my preparation very seriously, to be frank, very too much stress also. So that I come to know that when I gave my 2018 attempt. Seriously, 2 days before I was ill and I can't able to write exam also, but still I thought, so 1 year I prepared for this, so I have to do that. So I went and I requested in his letter, I have to go back to my home. Please send me. But he told that your attempt is already counted. It is second attempt, so you have to do. So he only did my bubbling and all. See, bear me because it's a very long story I have to tell you. So 1 hour I took rest in my examination hall and I started writing for 1 hour, remaining 1 hour. And now I got 108 in my first paper. And second paper I can't able to write also because I was not feeling well. Many people told it's stress. It's not stress. I believe that it's not stress. But in second paper, however, I'm getting 64. And I know that I'm going to fail this exam in 2018. So 1 month, I know how I faced. And I forgot my best friend even. Means like, I know what I spent everything with him and I forgot his name. And I know the subject what I studied in these 2 years and I forgot everything. So what will be my third attempt?
Ma'am, no offense to that, but could you keep your question little short?
Yes, this is like my third attempt, so I have to start a new start for me. So can you please suggest me the best way? So how I have to recall my all the things? Because 1 month I lost my track of current affairs. So now after listening to these topper talks and all, still I'm feeling like I have to be there. So please suggest me how I have to go for my third attempt. See, which I forgot, it should be on my track. So can you please suggest me? To you only, Anudeep sir, because I thought that you will tell the root cause. That's why.
That is very long.
Where to start? See, I think the problem is not as much in books or materials that you know what to study or where to study. It's all about you taking too much stress and anxiety just before the exam. And it's common to all the aspirants. I was nervous before my mains, I was nervous before my interview. But the point is, how long you want to perpetuate that, right? Would you want to be depressed for an hour or would you want to be depressed for a week? And there is a tremendous difference between both of them. You know, 1 hour you feel bad about yourself, your preparation, and then you take some time off and then you come back and read. That is one thing. But if you completely wipe off 1 week from your schedule, that's a major loss. So your problem is not that you are feeling low. Your problem is that you are feeling low and stressful for a prolonged period of time. And my only suggestion is, you know, you can try meditation. You know, mindfulness meditation is something that has really helped me, and I keep telling to others as well that irrespective of UPSC or not, you know, our mind is something that is trainable, as A.K. Khan sir has said. Just as you train your physical body, you can train your mental alertness, focus through meditation. And it keeps you away from all the stress and anxiety that are majorly, definitely part of our preparation. So there are many resources on the internet. Probably you can try taking it up as a hobby. Even if whether you clear or not, that is irrespective of that, but it will definitely help you stay sane, stay focused, stay calm, and not be anxious just before you face a big situation like an exam or an interview. Thank you.
Wonderful.
This video is brought to you by AKSIAS.